Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. In another narration by Ibn Abi Dunya in his book Sabr wa Thawab Alayh, his treatise entitled Patience and the Reward of Being Patient, he mentioned a very important narration for us, which shows us so many benefits. And in fact, it's imperative we'll just look at the apparent clear meanings from the hadith, and hopefully we'll have a chance to take a look at some of the explanations or the shuruhat of the ulama, the scholars who explain this, as this is a hadith that is collected in Bukhari. And it's a very important narration which shows us the importance of patience, of being patient when we have difficulty, and showing and illustrating the patience of the Salaf Salih, the radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, meaning the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and the tabi'een wa tabi' tabi'een, and then those who follow them in righteousness until the day of judgment. So in this narration, it shows us also to be patient, and not, this is a lesson for even those people who are tested with takfir, meaning that their hearts have been corrupted by wanting to declare other Muslims as disbelievers, maybe perhaps to build themselves up in their own image, maybe perhaps as a tazkiyah for themselves, maybe perhaps it makes them feel better to know that someone else is misguided. Whatever the reasons for it, it shows us how the tabi'een and how the sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, how they were, that they didn't rebel against the Muslim authority. Listen to this hadith. قال حدثني محمد بن إدريس الهندلي قال حدثنا أبو وليد التيلياسي قال سمعت عثمان بن زائدة يحدث عن زبير بن عدي قال دخلنا على أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه فشوكان عليه الحجاج فقال اتقوا الله واصبروا فإنه ليس من عام إلا والذي بعده أشد منه حتى تقوم الساعة قال عثمان سمعت مسيع يحدث عن زبير بن عدي عن أنس قال سمعت ذلك من نبيكم صلى الله عليه وسلم رواه البخاري. In this hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, which illustrates for us the importance of patience, Anas ibn Malik, some of the tabi'een, they went to Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and they complained about Hujjaj, because Hujjaj was killing the believers. In his oppressiveness, he was killing the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Can you think of a sin greater than that? Of course not. It's a very extreme sin that someone could do, but still be in the fold of Islam. We're not talking about shirk or kufr. It's not on the level of just total disbelief. But this person was killing and fighting the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. He was a great oppressor, a wicked sinner in this respect. So then they were complaining to Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, and he said, what did he respond radiyallahu ta'ala anhu with that hikmah, that wisdom of the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in? This shows the wisdom, and it shows us the madhab and the methodology of the Salaf al-Salih radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, that they weren't people to, even when they were being oppressed and their rights were being taken and their lives were being taken, their blood being made lawful by an oppressive ruler, that they didn't rebel. that they didn't call to revolution in Torah. They didn't call to protest. They didn't call to raising the sword and even speaking ill about the leader. But instead, they were patient. Instead, they made dua to rectify the leader. And instead, they followed the methodology of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who told us and ordered us to be patient. أسمع وطاع لمرأي المسلم فيما يحب فيما أحب وأكره ما لم يؤمر بمعصية فإذا أمر بمعصية فلا سمع ولا طاعة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered us to hear and obey the Muslim authority, and that which we love and that which we hate, as long as they don't call us to ma'asiyah, to sinfulness. And if they command you to ma'asiyah, then there's no hearing and obey in that ma'asiyah. Kama qala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ruahu Muslim. You'll find it in the chapter in Sahih Muslim, the chapter entitled the chapter of leadership. Back to the narration that we're discussing, which illustrates for us the importance of patience. Patience in all those in oppression. Patience in the difficulty we experience as individuals and as a community. قال اتقوا الله واصبروا. Fear Allah and be patient. For verily there isn't a time in which that the time that will come after it will be a should be more difficult. Until the day of judgment, letting us know that after trials we would have more trials. After trials we have more trials. Look at even in this time period. Look at the difficulty we face as a ummah. That before us, in the not so distant past, we had a khalifa, and that khalifa was dismantled. Now the ummah is divided, not only in sects and groups, but divided in different countries where you need a passport, you need a visa, you need this, in order to enter, even into the land of the Haramain, where where you have Mecca and Medina, to make Hajj and Umrah. And so, it shows us that the times only get more difficult, that we had leaders that were communists, that were Ba'athists, that were this, going so far from Islam, and the difficulty. We would experience after them even more difficulty, even more difficulty. But there's still khair. There's still khair. And there's still, and it's still upon us, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, be patient. Be patient. Asbiru. Ettaqullah wasbiru. Fear Allah and be patient. Fear Allah by adhering to His commands and staying away from those things He has prohibited. And being patient upon these great difficulties, great trials that we experience. The trial of a lack of leadership. The trials of difficult leadership. The trials of oppression. The trials of hatred between the Muslim Brotherhood. The trials of bid'ah. The trials of kufr and shirk that we experience. We have to be patient. We have to call to khair. We have to tamassak bi sunnah. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnata khulafa ar-rashidin al-mahdiin. Adwa alaykum bi nawadij wa iyyakum wa muhtathat al-umur. That we have to hold on. Alaykum bi sunnati. It's upon us the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the sunnah of the khulafa ar-rashidin al-mahdiin, meaning the sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. It's upon us that path. And it's upon us to be patient on these various trials that we experience day to day. And that we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance. We have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for relief from our trials. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam guaranteed us that there will always be a group that is victorious, that is patient, that will adhere to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Qala sallallahu alaihi wasallam, la tazal ta'ifatu min ummati zahirin ala haqq hatta yatihum amrullah wa hum ala dhalik. Or kama qala sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there will not cease to be a group from my nation, meaning that there would be a Taifata Mansura. There would be a group amongst the Muslims that are the saved sect. There would be a group that follows the minhaj of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that follows, that is the ahla athar, ahla hadith, and the other alqab that are mentioned in the nusus. That there would always be a victorious group, the victorious party. La tazal ta'ifatun min ummati zahirin ala haqq, that is open and on the haqq, that they are on the haqq. Zahirin ala haqq, they're victorious on the truth. La yadurruhum man khadalahum, and no one will harm them. who opposes them, who differs with them, who disagrees with them, who attacks them, who accuses them of terrorism, who accuses them of extremism, who accuses them of being Wahhabi, who accuses them of this name or that name or something outside the religion. Hatta tukum as-sa'ah, until the day of judgment. So this victorious group, they're patient. They're patient on ta'atillah. They're patient on the methodology of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the minhaj as-salaf as-salih radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and they're patient until they meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through all these difficulties and these difficult trials and tribulations that we face. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us to be from amongst them, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ikhlas, with thabat, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help and bless Ahl Sunnah wherever they may be. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.